Hello there, and thank you for tuning in to see what the world looks like through atheist eyes. I'm Frank Zindler, and I'm your host for this series of programs that I prepared for American Atheist Television. Although I am dedicated to portraying the world from an atheist viewpoint, today I have to change a bit. In the interest of being as fair and balanced as Fox News, the American Atheist News Network has requested that I teach the controversy, that I balance out our atheist-biased view of science with a more orthodox Christian insight. So today, in order to present a more fair and balanced view on the politically controversial topic of global warming, I am going to be joined by the Righteous Reverend Madrigal Fritzlschleimer, the senior pastor of St. Augustine's Scots-Afrikaaner Dutch Reformed Lutheran Church of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. So, for a fair and balanced view of our warming world, here's Fritzlschleimer. It is my unexpected duty to have to introduce to you today the Righteous Reverend Madrigal Fritzlschleimer. He's the senior pastor at the St. Augustine's Scots-Afrikaaner Dutch Reformed Lutheran Church in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Pastor Fritzlschleimer, welcome to Through Atheist Eyes. Pastor Fritzlschleimer,
I just want to say hello to my mother in Pretoria. Hello, Mama! I miss you so much.
Pastor Fritzlschleimer.
Don't worry about me being on
Pastor,
this
welcome to my
dangerously
show.
Heretical program in this evil studio. I am not really in hell. I am armed with the truth of the Holy Scriptures. Besides, I still have the garlic necklace you gave me when I graduated from the seminary.
Pastor Fritzlschleimer, welcome to Through Atheist Eyes.
Glory be to the Father. Yeah. The airplane I rode in from Milwaukee actually did fly through the air. Of course, it could have been a trick of the devil. We know he took his Jesus into Jerusalem and set him on the pinnacle of the temple. That's in Matthew chapter 4, verse 5. For all I know, that too might have been an airplane trick. Anyhow, I'm just so glad I packed along some extra underlinen.
Pastor Fritzlschleimer, welcome to Through Atheist Eyes. Pastor Fritzlschleimer?
Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion hath light with darkness? That is 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 14.
Okay. I see this is going to be a tough assignment. Pastor Fritzlschleimer, I hope you don't mind if I just call you Schleimer. Your full name is a little bit too much for me to try to pronounce in rapid discourse.
The legions of Beelzebub have called me worse.
When I asked Fox News for an authority to give me an alternative opinion on global warming, they recommended you highly. And so I've invited you to my program to tell us just why a climate expert such as you doesn't accept the reality of global warming.
You ask why I don't accept the crazy idea of global warming. Well, it's completely unbiblical.
How can it be unbiblical? Where does the Bible say anything at all? Where does the Bible have an opinion on global warming?
Oh, good Lord. Have you atheists never studied the Bible? For there to be such a thing as global warming, There has to be a globe. We know from the Holy Scriptures that the earth is not a globe. The earth is not a sphere. The earth is flat. No globe, no global warming. Q-E-D.
Well, whether or not the earth is a globe, the whole world is getting warmer and warmer. The ice caps and the glaciers are melting at an accelerating pace.
Glaciers melting, maybe. But ice caps? That is impossible. If the earth not be a globe, there is no top part and no bottom part on which to put a cap. How silly!
Oh my God. I can't believe this. How can you deny that the level of greenhouse gases in the Earth's atmosphere is at an all-time high? Microbubbles of atmosphere trapped in Antarctic ice cores show that the current level of carbon dioxide is the highest it's been in 800,000 years.
You are making me laugh. 800,000 years? This October, the world will just be 6,018 years old, as Archbishop Usher has proven from his scientific analysis of the Holy Bible.
Good God! Have you never heard of geology? The 6 million varv layers in the Green River Shale alone show just by themselves that the Earth has to be at least 3 million years old. Anyway, the carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere are the highest they've ever been. What do you say to that?
Carbon dioxide? You talk about carbon dioxide. That is completely unbiblical. There is no carbon dioxide in the Bible. Carbon dioxide is a heresy, a lie of Satan.
How can you dismiss carbon dioxide just because the ignorant authors of the Bronze Age didn't understand the kinetic theory of gases? There's no television in the Bible either, but here we are on television.
Of course, we don't find the word television in the Bible. That is because television is a bastard word. A word made up from two different languages. The first part, tele, comes from Greek, a holy biblical language, and it means at a distance. The second part, vision, that comes from Latin, the pagan language of the Romish Catholic Church, and means seeing. That makes television a bastard word, a word we cannot allow in Holy Scriptures. But just because the word does not appear in the Bible, that doesn't mean that the holy authors did not know about the concept of seeing at a distance. In Matthew chapter 4, verse 8, we are told that the devil took with Jesus up into an exceeding high mountain, and he showed him all the kingdoms of the world. Now, that is real television.
Oh boy. Well, let me tell you about carbon dioxide. Since the birth of the Industrial Revolution, people have been burning greater and greater amounts of coal and oil and natural gas. This produces carbon dioxide, a greenhouse gas.
Coal and oil are biblical, completely biblical. Gas is not. We know from the Holy Scriptures that coal and oil are gifts of God, to be used and enjoyed. The Bible tells us neither about greenhouses nor neither about gases. All this talk about global warming is a lie of Satan.
Look, if you know nothing about geography, geology, chemistry, climatology, or any science at all, how can you have a credible opinion on the subject of global warming?
I know nothing about geography, about science. Really? Were I not an authority about true science, do you think I would be a paid consultant for Fox News?
Well, I see this is going nowhere. Pastor Schleimer, I don't see any point in continuing this discussion. Thank you for joining us today to give us...
I haven't had a chance to tell you about how a dream of the prophet Daniel predicted that the temperature of the earth would increase in the latter days increasing sinfulness of Democrats, and that homosexuality would be increasing, and that Obamacare would be forced upon the world.
Don't let that apologist Lee Strobel hornswoggle you into betting your hard-earned money in the rigged crapshoot called Christianity. If you think Strobel's book almost makes sense, it's time to reboot your brain by reading Dr. Robert Price's devastating rebuttal, The Case Against the Case for Christ. The world will make sense once again. Order The Case Against the Case for Christ from Amazon or from the American Atheist website. In The Case Against the Case for Christ, Dr. Price even refutes Strobel's lame and misleading attempt to disprove my essay, Where Jesus Never Walked, which showed that Nazareth, Capernaum, and other cities in the Gospels were fictive places. Price devastatingly rebuts the Reverend Mr. Strobel's apologetic claims. Don't be an unarmed atheist in the shootout war of religious aggression. Order The Case Against the Case for Christ today.